Hi class, in this tutorial basically you will see how to handle multiple exceptions. Till now we have just seen a general except statement and how to handle zero division errors. But what if you have a program and that you want to handle multiple kind of exceptions, right? So for that we will see this code. Initially we are having the clear statement, that's fine, and we have a numerator and denominator, right? So till now you have seen we get two kinds of error. If we have zero, for let me just show you very quickly. Okay, it does not require. So first is a zero division error. Zero division error is caused when your denominator is of int kind. And let us make this a string. Just have a look here. This is zero division error. And finally, you have a type error because integers cannot be divided by string. Now we will see how can we handle zero division error and also type errors, right? Let me uncomment this line. As we saw in the previous tutorial, we have multiple except statements, right? So this round brackets is optional. You can even remove this round bracket. So let us remove this for zero division error. So now let us initially keep this zero as an integer zero. So what will happen? This will not be executed because in the try block, division will cause an error, zero division error. And it will actually match the zero division error. Since zero division error is there, there was some error in the try clause and I am printing the zero division error. Just let us try to execute this statement. So you can see there was some error in the try clause, zero division error. So basically we printed this statement because obviously we knew because when integer is divided, we get the zero division error. Now let us make a string. Now what error will string cause? It will cause a type error. So when this statement basically pops up an exception in the Python interpreter, this is skipped because this was a type error which does not match with this. It actually matches with type error. Again, the round brackets are optional, but I will explain you why I have put here. So in this case, this will be printed. There was some error in the type error, right? Now you see there was some error in the type error, right? This won't come because it's just like a switch case statement. Only one of the exception actually executes. Fine. So in this case, we are getting the type error. And now why did I put the brackets here? So for example, if you want to check for 10 types of exceptions, right? So in this case, entering except 10 times is still okay, but the code will look bad, right? So what I can do, I can just combine. Okay, we will see. Okay, let me show you in this tutorial. I will remove this line, this or this, right? So in this case, basically I say ki when you divide these two things, check for two exceptions, zero division error or type error, right? So let us execute the code and see what happens. So there was some error in the try clause, zero division error or type error, right? So this is how you basically handle multiple exceptions. Let me just undo the program because I have the same program written in the bottom, right? So in this case, see, you can specify two manners in two ways. You can either have each exception on each except clause, or you can basically combine the except statement by combining the exceptions. So it's a programmer's choice. In this manner, your code will look more beautiful. But in the above choice, you will actually exactly come to know which was the exception which was thrown by the interpreter. So let us execute the statement. So you can have as many types of exceptions that you want. And for that, you need to use a tuple. So if you see, this is basically a tuple of exceptions. Right? So that's it for class. So that's it for this video.